Joe's gonna pick you up. Because I live on the other side of town? Ah, jeez, I am never going that way. No, I will still meet you.
What did you say that for?
What?
I heard you say I was never gonna lose weight.
I did not say that. What was that?
Put the phone down. Put the phone down.
What is wrong with you?
You said I was never going to lose weight. I heard you tell Mom that.
Jeannie, why would I say that?
You know that I always think you're better than me. You're always putting me down.
Will you stop crying? Okay, listen. You said you came over to tell me something important, right? So what is it?
I can't talk about it now.
Oh, you fucking better talk about it. After all this. Come on, just spit it out.
Get me a glass of water.
Oh, fine. There.
So, what is it you wanted to tell me?
Why did you say I was never going to lose any weight?
Oh, Jimmy, will you stop with that? You look fine. Okay, now what did you want to tell me? You know, Steven's gonna be home soon. You don't want him to see you like this, do you?
No.
Okay. So? Well? What did you want to tell me?
Well, it's not something I'm proud of.
Oh, Ginny. Listen, you've always told me everything, okay? And I have not been a perfect human being myself. So, just take a deep breath. And out with it.
Well, you know, I've been on Weight Watchers now for 6 weeks, and I was feeling good about myself.
Mm-hmm.
Even though I ate that Snickers bar for lunch on Saturday instead of my hard-boiled egg.
Uh-huh, but then you...
got back on the plan, yes! But I was feeling terrible about that Snickers bar, so I came over here to talk to you about it.
You did? When?
Saturday at 4 p.m.
Oh, yeah, I was out shopping with Evelyn. Sorry.
That's okay. Because I ended up talking to Steven.
To Steven?
And I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
You're so sorry. So sorry about Steven.
We didn't mean for it to happen. I just felt so terrible and he was just trying to comfort me.
He was trying to comfort you.
We didn't mean for it to go that far. He really loves you, Eileen. He kept telling me how much he loves you. And we didn't want to hurt you, but it just happened.
You didn't want to hurt. It just happened.
Don't you feel better?
I don't feel better. Don't forget to call Mom. She has a doctor's appointment tomorrow. I told her you'd take her.
Sure.
Okay.
Thank you for being so understanding.
Okay. Here we go. Out the door.
Drive safe.
What's doing? You look kind of tired?
I'm fine.
Okay.
Ginny came over today.
Oh, really? What'd she want?
Oh, she was really upset, crying. You know Ginny. Did she come over here on Saturday?
Saturday? No, and I was here all day watching the game with Dan, remember?
Oh. What time was that?
Oh, I don't know. Started around 1, you know?
So she didn't come over here to talk to me because she ate a Snickers instead of a hard-boiled egg for lunch?
What? Honey, What's wrong?
The Snickers bar? Is Ginny having a fit about her weight again?
Well, yeah, but she said...
You gotta stop letting her get to you, babe. She's always roping you into her little circle of panic.
Steven.
I know how you get when you're with her. Yes, babe?
Ginny says that you and she had sex on Saturday.
What?
She said you were comforting her about the Snickers bar and the hard-boiled egg, and it just happened.
And you believe her?
Of course. I don't. But...
what? How could we have sex with Dan here? Did we both have sex with him?
Well, why would she say it?
Because she's batshit crazy, that's why. You always, I can't believe it. You always take her... She's obviously trying to undermine our marriage. How could you possibly believe her?
Well, does she really hate me that much? Why? I always try to be sympathetic to her weight issues and her depressions and all of her bad relationships.
Maybe that's it, Eileen. She resents you and your perfect marriage and your perfect life. That's the way she sees it. I don't know why she came up with this cockamamie story now.
Well, maybe she's finally gone over the edge.
Honey, why don't you get some rest, okay? I know this has been a lot for both of us. I'll make something to eat. Okay? And then just lie down. I just wanted to verify that he was here Saturday watching the game with me. Dan? Hi. Are you still up? Oh, thank God. Dan, look. I need you. No, everything's fine.
This is so embarrassing. It's my sister.
I just need you to come over here, please.
To testify. Bad word. No, I need you to come and tell Eileen and her sister Ginny. Yeah, that's her. Please tell them what we were doing here together on Saturday. Yes! That's it. Well, I think it'd be better if he came over in person. Okay. He's coming.
Oh, this is ridiculous. Getting our neighbors mixed up in this.
We need it settled.
Steven.
That's it. He's here. Here we go. Dan, I'm so sorry about this, man. All right, please.
Tell Ginny and Eileen... what we did together on Saturday.
Okay, we watched the Giants game and had a couple of beers. Why?
No reason. Just a big misunderstanding, that's all.
See, Ginny, I don't know why you're lying like this.
Oh, I see. You're all in on it. You want me to think I'm crazy. It's gaslight! Eileen, you have always hated me! What are you going to do now? Call the mental institution and have me committed?
Ginny, no.
Stay away from me.
Whoa, hold on. Hold on. Eileen, I'm going to take over your mother's. I think that'd be best. I know she's got some medication over there, okay?
No,
you shouldn't be with her just now. Come on. Ginny, out. Ginny, out. Out the door.
How did you know he wanted you to lie for him?
I didn't. At first, I thought he knew about Saturday.
Well, all right. Okay. You win. I'm in love with you. Well, all right. Okay. You win. Baby, what can I do? I'll do anything you say. It's just got to be that way. Well, all right. Okay. You win. I'm in love with you. Well, all right. Okay. You win. Baby, what can I do? Anything you say, I'll do. As long as it's me and you. Oh!